Hi, good morning everyone. My name is Gagandeep Singh and I am a faculty with Study Khazana. Today we will be starting with economics as a concept. Now, first, what is managerial economics? Managerial economics is a concept when we started to take decisions. What is a decision? Let's understand it in a very layman language. Layman. What is a layman first? Layman is a concept when we actually understand any particular topic on a simpler grounds. Let's understand managerial economics on those grounds only. Now, what is a managerial economics? Let's understand it via a small example. Take this as PVR. These are the number of seats which are utilized and these are the remaining seats which are unallocated. Utilized, unallocated. These are the words what you have already covered in your graduation, right? In your graduation, right, what you have already covered is allocations, efficiency, productivity. Now we move on to the application side of a managerial perspective. Let's understand this instance to understand what the base basically of managerial economics. So in this category, these are the seats which are fully allocated and utilized, whereas in this category, right, the seats are allocated, it is being shared by the PVR company, but in this category the seats are not utilized. Now what is the challenge out here? The basic challenge in this category is that these seats remain not utilized because of multiple factors. Now we need to understand in managerial economics what are the decision related factors. Now the decision related factors, what we call it as multiple concepts, right, starting from production. Are we producing a particular product on a nicer terms, whether it is required, right, what is the demand, what is the supply of that particular product line. Let's understand this in more detail. Now, managerial economics initially was the technique of taking decisions in management. Once we take a decision, immediately we cannot take that particular decision back. Today, we will be covering a small business model of this as a concept. The concept starts from PESTEL. Now what is PESTEL? Now PESTEL is a technique of understanding whether we can launch a particular product in a particular country or not. We need to understand the entire economy or the business environment. As a business person or a business student, you need to understand this business model in the first introductory session only. Now, what is PESTEL? It stands for political. Now, what will be covering under political? It can be multiple categories. Main koi bhi product, koi bhi service. What is a product, sir? What is a service now? Now, let's understand first the basic concept. What is a product versus a service? The product is a basic concept when we generally call it as a good or anything which is tangible in nature. What do you understand by the word service? Services are taken as a basic service or offering that we are giving it to the society. In this category, it is known as intangible as a concept. Now, intangible and tangible are two different aspects. Anything which is tangible, we can touch, feel, that becomes your good. Anything which we cannot touch, we can only feel that services, right? So that is what is known as service. A normal question that we people ask is, what is a debit card? So this is what the application, what we need to understand in your management. What is a debit card? Is it a good? Or is it a service? It is not a good, it is not a service as well. So this is a concept of goods based services. goods-based services, what is it, sir? Initially, it is not taken only as a good. अगर मेरे पास सिर्फ डेबिट कार्ड होगा और पीछे बैकग्राउंड में सर्विसेज नहीं होंगी तो मैं उसको यूज कैसे करूंगा. अगर ये हम बोलें कि ये डेबिट कार्ड सिर्फ सर्विसेज है, दैट इज नॉट टेकन एज अ गुड. नाउ अंडरस्टैंड, इट इज अ गुड्स बेस्ड सर्विस कॉन्सेप्ट. पहले वो गुड है, बाद में वो क्या पर्टिकुलर चीज है, सर्विस. ऐसे ही अंडरस्टैंड सर्विस बेस्ड गुड्स कौन से हो सकते हैं. मैं पहले कोई पर्टिकुलर सर्विस लूं और उसके बाद वही पर्टिकुलर कंपनी मेरे को गुड्स दे. थिंक फ्रॉम अ ऑनलाइन पर्सपेक्टिव, ई कॉमर्स पर्सपेक्टिव. यस, मल्टीपल पीपल आर गेटिंग द करेक्ट आंसर. फ्लिपकार्ट, एमेजॉन, हम पहले उस साइट पे जाते हैं, हमने उस साइट के ऊपर पहले सर्विसेज ली, फिर बाद में हमारे को क्या चीज मिल गई, गुड्स. सो वी कवर्ड फोर कॉन्सेप्ट्स हियर, गुड्स, सर्विसेज एंड द एप्लीकेशन बेस्ड कॉन्सेप्ट्स, दैट इज goods based services and services based goods. Clear with the approach? Let's understand the decisions again. The first decision what we started with is a political one. In political decisions of economy, right, what we actually take first, war conditions in a country. Second, international relationships. Kisi country ke andar war to nahi ho rahi, main apna product launch kar dun, mere ko koi challenge to nahi hoga. किसी रीजन में प्रोडक्ट लॉन्च कर दो इंडिया के अंदर, वहां चैलेंज तो नहीं होगा. लेट्स अंडरस्टैंड फ्रॉम अ सिंपलर केस स्टडी. यू अंडरस्टूड द केस स्टडी फॉर टाटा नैनो. टाटा नैनो इज द चीपेस्ट कार, राइट, टू बी प्रोड्यूस्ड इन इंडियन ग्राउंड्स. नाउ लेट्स अंडरस्टैंड वेदर इट इज सक्सेसफुल और नॉट. इनिशियली व्हेन टाटा नैनो स्टार्टेड विद दिस पर्टिकुलर कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ प्रोडक्शन, राइट, दे मूव्ड इनटू अ पर्टिकुलर एरिया बाय द नेम सिंगूर. Singur is a part of north of West Bengal. In West Bengal, at that particular point of time, there was a chief minister by the name Mamata Banerjee. So Mamata Banerjee initially didn't wanted that the farmers' land to be troubled. So in that category, right, she did not give that particular land to Tata as a company. So Tata then moved or shifted their brand from one particular place to a different location, that is they moved from West Bengal and they moved it to Gujarat, and then they started with that particular operation. Understand the kind of losses they suffered in not critically examining that particular West Bengal market. So Tata suffered huge losses in that particular category. Clear? Understood with this particular concept? Okay, how war is impacting an Indian economy? Say for example, what are the countries which is neighboring us? It is Pakistan, China, Nepal, Sri Lanka, Myanmar, Bhutan, and multiple others as well. Now understand, are we friendly with these countries? In case we are not, that is again a political barrier. There will be not of much of investments to be circulated in our country. The money supply from the rest of the world will be less, and we will be entertaining less of investors and less of foreign direct investments. The second concept that we started here is economic. What is an economic concept now? In economic, we understand multiple simpler and the shorter concepts. You must have covered it in your 12th classes as well as your graduation as well. A small recap, right, what we actually cover in this business model is under the economic category, the starting point comes as a GDP. What do you understand by the word GDP? GDP is a smaller concept that we study under micro plus macro economics as well. Under macroeconomics, what is GDP? It is the final value of goods and services produced in a domestic territory of a country in one particular year. क्या क्या बना रहे हैं हम, right? Under GDP. In GDP, there are three sectors. आपने सबने पढ़े होंगे, there are three smaller sectors. What are these sectors? First, primary sector. Second, secondary sector. And third, tertiary sector. In primary sector, there are different concepts. The concept starts from agriculture. Agriculture itself is a very vast field. Initially, 72.7% of the population at the time of independence were only working in agriculture. Then they slowly and gradually moved on, and multiple fields under the primary category improved. So what are the fields under the agriculture now? So it is known as agriculture and related activities, or some books will always share that it is agriculture and allied activities. Okay, agriculture and allied activities. What are allied activities now? Farming, cultivation, harvesting, are these allied activities? Answer is no. These are a part of agriculture. These are some techniques. So for example, you must have studied in your lower classes the concept of terrace farming, crop rotation, step farming. So these are a part which is specifically designed for agriculture as a unit. The next part which actually comes under the allied categories are fisheries. Fishes se related kuch bhi kaam, that is a part under agriculture as a broader category. Poultry se related koi bhi kaam, that is again hens and hens ke aage aap eggs jo aap sell karte ho, that is a part of your poultry. The third category under here is dairy farming, milk and milk related products. The fourth category under this category is your horticulture. Now what is a horticulture? Horticulture includes two smaller things. One is vegetables and the second one is fruits. And the last concept is floriculture. Now what is floriculture? You know that there is a market which is expanding at an exponential rate, that is for flowers, right? So that is the concept of floriculture. So these are the concepts which are being covered under the primary sector of agriculture. The second concept what we need to understand here is the secondary sector. What is a secondary sector? Any sector which includes industries, raw materials, manufacturing. These are different specific words which constitute a secondary sector. What is a secondary sector? Any sector which is transforming a raw material and converting into a finished goods. Maine cotton liya, raw material, uski aage processing hui, aur wo usne kya bana diya? Cotton shirt, cotton t-shirt, cotton silk sari. It can be anything. And the third category or the third sector what we cover in your GDP is tertiary sector. Tertiary is also being replicated as a service sector. Now what are the services that is being included? All the services, but we understand the major ones: transportation, communication, banking, insurance, warehousing, storage, etc. So these are the part of your GDP. So GDP is one, per capita income is another, GDP deflation is another, next is your inflation, next is your HDI, that is Human Development Index. So these are small bits and pieces parts that we cover under your economy. So that is a part of your economic point under the PESTEL analysis. The next category what we understand is your social. Now what is a social as a concept? Social is a very simpler concept of understanding the caste, creed, culture, tradition, religion, customs, values of a particular area. Let's understand two or three under this. What is a belief first? A belief is what we people feel, right? So this is correct. Now belief can be, cow is a sacred animal. Guys, cow is a sacred animal what we take it in India. Outside world, it is not the belief. So for Indians, we have this particular belief that cow is a sacred animal for us. What is a value? Value is touching the feet of the elders. Okay, that is the value again specifically to an Indian continent. In case we generally call it as, say, outside world, so for a very simple example, Japanese people bow their head. That is a value of respecting the other as a human being. So these are the specific instances where we can discuss this topic. The next topic what is covered under this category is your technological. Technology constitutes four small concepts. Now, what are these concepts? Let's understand in a smaller pace. First, upgradation. Second, innovation. Third, invention. And fourth, R&D. What is upgradation now? First, upgradation is a concept of moving a particular product or a service from one level to another. A very smaller and a layman example. Har roj aap karte ho, right? Kya aa jata hai aapke paas? WhatsApp update. WhatsApp update mein kya karte hai? It is an upgrade what the company has been sharing over a period of time. iPhone update, Android update. So this is when we are moving from one particular upgrade to the next level. It is known as upgradation. The second concept what we cover under this category is innovation. Innovation is a concept of moving from one particular product, introducing a new particular product in this category. हमारा एक पर्टिकुलर तरीका है एक पर्टिकुलर चीज को करने का, लेकिन उसी चीज की जगह हम उस चीज को बेटर ऑफ कैसे कर सकते हैं, कुछ और प्रोडक्ट कैसे बना सकते हैं. पहले भी शादियां होती थी, अब क्या होने लग गया, शादी.com. Someone has created a new way, right, or a new idea. Click recently, right, there has been a speech of Sundar Pichai. उन्होंने एक कॉन्सेप्ट लॉन्च किया, दैट इज द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ गूगल लेंस. Google Lens is a new concept which is there in the market. आप एक फ्लावर के ऊपर अपना फोन रखोगे, इमीडिएट बेसिस के ऊपर आपको पता चल जाएगा ये फ्लावर कौन सा है. That is the concept of innovation. The last concept or the last example under this category is the example what I am giving for Elon Musk. Everyone knows across the world who is Elon. Elon is a person who started with the fastest cars, right? That is Tesla. They have moved onto the better processing field, that is PayPal. Now he has started with a newer concept, that is a boring company. Now what is a boring company? Normal bhi to hum log travel karte hain, sir boring ki kya requirement hai? So he has a vision that he will be creating 30 different tunnels, right, for our vehicles. Usse kya hoga? Fast hona shuru ho jayega. This is a concept of a smaller in innovation. The third concept does not practically hold true. Bahut zyada saalon ke andar ek baar ye particular cheez hoti hai. This is a concept of invention. Aaj se kitne saal pehle ek particular bulb aaya tha. So wo bulb aane ka kya matlab hua? That was invented by someone. So newer product jo invention hi pehli baar ho rahi hai, this is a concept of invention. Rare hai, iske upar utna zyada hame focus nahi karna on right now. The last concept here is R&D, which is the most and the critical aspect of every company. R&D stands for research and development. Research and development was initially only pioneered to pharmaceutical industry earlier, telecom industry earlier. Now it has moved to all the industries. Ek bahut chota sa example R&D ka. Hum master chefs dekhte hain. Master chef ke andar aapko multiple products de diye jaate hain. Ye lijiye products aur isse kuch particular product banaiye. So that is the concept of R&D. वो कुछ रिसर्च कर रहे हैं, डेवलप कर रहे हैं और फाइनली वो पर्टिकुलर प्रोडक्ट को बना रहे हैं. R&D व्हेनेवर वी स्टडी इज अ कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ डिस्कवरी. इट कैन बी डिस्कवरी ऑफ अ न्यू प्रोडक्ट. ओके, लेट्स अंडरस्टैंड ऑफ अनदर एग्जांपल जो एक बहुत पुराने टाइम में स्टार्ट हुआ था, विक्स एक्शन 500+. दिस इज अ कंपनी दैट एवरीवन नोस. विक्स इनिशियली इट वॉज अ मेडिसिन ओनली टू बी टेकन फॉर कफ. मेरा गला खराब है, मैंने वो मेडिसिन ले ली. कफ के बाद वही चीज आपकी कोल्ड के ऊपर भी आ गई तो विक्स एक्शन बन गया. वही चीज आपकी बॉडी के अंदर पेन हो गई तो विक्स एक्शन 500 बन गया. वही चीज आपकी बॉडी के अंदर टेम्परेचर भी आ गया तो विक्स एक्शन 500+ बन गया. मेडिसिन 4 इंक्रीज नहीं कर रहे, मेडिसिन सिर्फ एक ही है. दिस इज अ कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ R&D. सारी चीजें उसी में डाल दो, इन वन कैप्स्यूल यू विल फाइंड आउट मल्टीपल कैटेगरीज. सो दिस वॉज अ लास्ट कॉन्सेप्ट अंडर टेक्नोलॉजिकल फील्ड. The next concept is economic or environmental. So we study it together, that is economic environment. Economic environment concept constitute multiple categories like air, water, land and noise pollution. In this environment, it is being polluted every day. Simpler to start off with air pollution. What do you understand by the concept of air pollution? किस किस मीन से होती है एयर पॉल्यूशन? नॉर्मल डे टू डे व्हीकल्स, नॉर्मल फैक्ट्रीज एंड अदर कॉन्सेप्ट्स एज वेल. लैंड पॉल्यूशन किस चीज से होती है? कोई भी केमिकल्स हम लैंड के ऊपर फेंक दें, गार्बेज फेंक दें एंड अदर कॉन्सेप्ट एज वेल. The third category under this stands for your noise pollution. What do you understand by noise pollution? Noise pollution is a concept जब हम जोर जोर से कोई एक पर्टिकुलर चीज को मार्केट में फैलाना शुरू करें फ्रॉम अ नॉइस पर्सपेक्टिव. फॉर अ वेरी सिंपल एग्जाम्पल द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ लाउड स्पीकर्स. हम कोई भी जागरण कर रहे हैं उसमें से बहुत जोर जोर से लाउड स्पीकर बज रहे हैं. गुरुद्वारे है उसके अंदर जोर जोर से लाउड स्पीकर बज रहे हैं. दैट इज एक्चुअली नॉट गुड फॉर द सोसाइटी. एक लिमिटेड लेवल के ऊपर वो चीज होगी इट विल बी वंडरफुल. इसी के ऊपर गवर्नमेंट हैज ऑल्सो गिवन टू स्मॉल लॉज दैट वी नीड टू स्टडी एज अ मैनेजर. द फर्स्ट लॉ इज से नो टू लाउड स्पीकर आफ्टर 10. आई थिंक दिस एवरीवन नोज. देयर इज अ सेकंड लॉ दैट इज 200 मीटर्स कोई भी हॉस्पिटल के आसपास कोई भी बैंक्वेट हॉल कोई भी मैरिजेस नहीं होनी चाहिए. सो दैट इज द सेकंड लॉ विच द गवर्नमेंट हैज गिवन अंडर दिस कैटेगरी. And the last concept what we need to cover is legal aspect, right? So what is a legal aspect? The legal concept institute multiple things like taxes, tariffs, quotas, and restrictions. Now let's understand two smaller concepts: taxes and tariffs. मैं कोई भी business करूं मुझे tax देना है. Answer is yes. मैं कोई भी product launch करूं मेरे को कुछ देना है to the government. Answer is yes. Now it is a concept of taxes. Taxes are of multiple types that will be covered under the government budget chapter, right? But a smaller concept that we can understand here is income tax. Meri income ke upar koi bhi tax charge hoga, that is to be paid to the government. Service tax, main koi bhi services dunga, uske upar mere ko charge government ko dena hai? Answer is yes. So these are two types of taxes what we started with. One is a direct tax and one is an indirect tax. Multiple taxes that will be covered under this category is a part of government budget that we'll be covering soon. The next and the last topic for this first session is the scope. What covers managerial economics as a scope? So we will be covering multiple things in this particular chapters, right, which are coming ahead. Let's understand one by one. First that we'll be covering would be a part of your production chapter. Now what production will be talking about? Production is a concept of conversion of raw material and putting forward towards your finished goods. The second concept that we'll be covering in this syllabus is who is a consumer. Now what is a consumer and how is it different from a customer and a client? A consumer is a person who buys a product. A consumer is a person who uses a product. Which one is correct under this category? Buyer hai wo? Answer is no. He is not a buyer. So who is a buyer then? A buyer is a person who is actually a customer. Customer is a person who buys a product, whereas a consumer is a person who uses the product. Uses the product, or in MBA we need to write it as end user. वो फाइनली उस पर्टिकुलर प्रोडक्ट को यूज करता है और आगे उस पर्टिकुलर चीज के बेनिफिट्स रीप करता है. देयर इज अनदर कॉन्सेप्ट दैट वी नीड टू कवर अंडर द कंज्यूमर सेक्शन इज हु इज अ क्लाइंट. अ क्लाइंट इज अ पर्सन हु इज अ रिपीटेड बायर. मैं एक बार एक शॉप से बाय करूं फिर दोबारा उसी शॉप से बाय करूं फिर दोबारा उसी शॉप से बाय करूं आई विल ऑटोमेटिकली बिकम अ रिपीटेड बायर. इस कॉन्सेप्ट को बहुत ही सिंपलर मैनर के अंदर कैसे स्टडी करते हैं? अंडर अ सिंपलर कॉन्सेप्ट दैट इज अ ब्रांड पिरामिड. सो दीज आर द पीपल हु आर लॉयल टू अ बिजनेस. दीज आर द पीपल हु आर मूवर्स. दीज आर द पीपल हु आर स्विचर्स. Okay, so who is the loyal first? Loyal are the people who buys a particular product again and again repeatedly from one particular outlet. It can be an example for iPhones. It can be an example for Levi's jeans, right? Jockey and worldwide products as well. In India, generally people are loyal towards MDH, Patanjali, J&J, that is Johnson & Johnson's, Tata Salt. So these are specific examples of the loyalist people. How is it different from movers as a concept? What are the people who are movers? आज मैं एक particular जगह से एक product ले लेता हूँ, कल मैं फिर दोबारा किसी और जगह जाऊंगा वहां से दूसरा product लूंगा, फिर किसी और जगह जाऊंगा वहां से तीसरा product लूंगा, but over a period of time. So this is a basic difference between a mover and a switcher. Switcher is a person who is not a consumer for one particular outlet. They will consume from one particular outlet first, then they move on to the second outlet and the third outlet. How is it different from a mover? Mover stays there for a particular time period. मैं दो साल एक particular brand के साथ attached रहा, फिर मैं move कर गया. फिर किसी brand के साथ attached रहा, फिर मैं move कर गया. For a very simple example, earlier I used to buy a Nokia phone. Now I moved towards a better technology. I bought an iPhone. Again, in case iPhone is being replaced by some other company, we'll buy that particular phone. So I am moving as a customer. Clear with this particular approach? So this is a topic for consumer. The next topics that we'll be covering under this particular category is cost, markets, national income, government budget, investments, savings, and the last concept will be your foreign exchange. Let's quickly understand these topics and we'll be winding it up. What do you understand by the word cost? It is a 12th class concept again, right? Cost is anything what we are paying for producing a particular product. It can be divided under multiple categories like total fixed cost, total variable cost, marginal cost, and other stuff as well. What are different types of market that we'll be covering in our course? So these are different chapters what we'll be talking about, but only to give you a brief under the scope of managerial economics. Market includes multiple concepts, initially starting from perfect competition, monopoly, monopolistic competition, and oligopoly. So here we will not be only understanding these as a concept, but also how it is applied in your managerial economics. The next is your national income, what we'll be understanding. Here we'll be understanding what is a GDP, NNP, FC, that is your national income, NDP, FC. So here the concept for numericals comes. In government budget, it is a very vast topic that we'll be covering from expenditures to income of an Indian economy. So here we'll be understanding income, expenditure sources, and multiple other concepts as well. In investments and savings, we'll be understanding a simpler concept of how investment is being evolved. Here it is a concept of capital creation, plus how we can save that particular stuff in an Indian economy. Here we'll be understanding multiple concepts of equations, right? How y is equals to c plus s, what is ad, what is as, and these all concepts, what is a part, what we have covered in your graduation, it will be an application part in your managerial economics. And the last topic that we'll be touch basing on, it will be your foreign exchange. What is foreign exchange? Foreign exchange is when we are buying from one particular country and we are selling it to the other country as well. Importers, exporters as a concept, when we are using a currency, it is a concept of a foreign exchange. So these all will be a part of your first chapter. The entire course constitute multiple chapters, right? Starting from cost, production, pricing, and other parts as well. And slowly and gradually, we will be covering that as well. Last, the recap of this particular session, a simpler concept what we started from, what is a managerial economics? Managerial economics is taking decisions for future. Decisions includes two concepts. The first concept is goals. What is the goal of an organization? Goals can be survival, profit, and then the final will be your expansion. And the second category is forward planning. So in forward planning, generally we take it as a forecasting or prediction as a concept. Then we understood a smaller business model, that is a pestle approach. A pestle approach constitute political, economic, social, technological, legal, and environmental. Political. Political include war, international relationships with the countries, and the government stability. Economy. It includes GDP, per capita income, inflation, deflation, etc. Social, we constituted values, beliefs, tradition, religion, regions, etc. In technology, we constituted four different categories: upgradation, innovation, invention, and R&D. In environment, we constituted again four categories: air, water, land, and noise pollution. And the last category was legal, when we are actually talking about paying taxes, tariffs, quotas, and to the government. So we will continue from this in the coming sessions, and we'll be kick-starting with demand as a concept. Thank you for joining me onto my session.